Rowena Supercars, the Aston Martin DB5. So this is the DB5.
It is, yeah.
I've got many questions to ask about this car. Okay. I just noticed that this car doesn't go very fast.
It didn't, it say? It was very much a little bit like the DB10. So in the 1960s, it's very much a sports car.
It's back seat as well.
It is, yeah.
And it's not like the other one, the interior.
No, this is a normal car, so this is, yeah. It's as it would have been for if you bought one as a road car.
This is David Brown Aston Martin.
Yeah, David Brown at the time was the owner of the company, that's where DB comes from. It's David Brown, so he put his mom and
dad. David Brown makes tractors.
He does, we did do, yeah.
Super
leather. Super leather, which means super light. So in Italian, it's a lightweight bodywork, aluminium bodywork.
Does this car go?
Wouldn't say, it probably would have been about 135, 140 miles an hour.
What is the size of this engine?
This particular car, I think it's a 4.7. It's got a vantage bank on the side.
How many cars were made of this one?
DB5, just over 1,000.
Over 1,000?
In total, yeah.
Over 1,000 DB5. That's a lot compared to 10.
10 DB, yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to have a peek through the window.
Sit if you like. It's wood on top of aluminium, so you see there's aluminium in the middle.
Yeah.
There's a layer of wood on top, and it's quite heavily lacquered.
Is that, where's the horn? Is the horn there?
I'm not sure. I wouldn't press it though, in case it goes off.
If it goes off and it's too loud, that's it. I wouldn't press it. It's a 5-speed gearbox, but in those days, that was amazing. But unfortunately now it's not that amazing. These dials are chrome. They're really amazing. They've made this car really nice. Lloyd, is there an ejector seat in this car?
Shall I sit on the other side and see if it works?
Yeah.
No, there isn't one in this car. But in the James Bond car, he did have an ejector seat.
Whoa.
Just like the DB10.
Press the ejector button, and then suddenly there's a big boingy thing, and then it pops up. Whoa, look at those. Look at those over there. Amazing. The seats are really comfortable. It's sleepy. The seats are so comfortable. It's easy getting out of the game. If you don't want to
check them.
Look at those wheels!
See, it's even got disc brakes as well, so these would have been added a little bit later on.
They look really, really nice. Seeing they're not white-walled.
Well, you might white-wall wheels. Might look a little bit strange on this one, but I'm sure some of them did have white-wall wheels.
Can I look at the
top? Yeah, push down. Find that one there.
Look at the back. This has been aboard this car.
It has, yeah.
Whoa. It doesn't have anything to do with the car, this number plate doesn't.
It's actually a number plate on the first James Bond car.
Oh.
So it's quite a famous number plate. So BMT 214A is the number on James Bond's.
Thank you very much, Lloyd, for letting me have a tour around DB5 and DB10.
No problem at all, it's a pleasure.
Thank you very much to Grange Aston Martin for letting me see the beautiful DB5 and the amazing DB10. And thank you very much for watching Rowena Supercars. That's Lloyd. I said it wrong. It's a tongue twister. It's hard to say it. Let's ask Lloyd about the DB10. Please subscribe on the amazing Aston Martin badge. So thank you very much, and I'll see you soon on Rowena Supercars.